I'm trying to bring a voice, maybe a voice that wasn't heard, of West London. So I was just trying to give an eclectic viewpoint of the place I love and grow and the place that I cherish in my heart.
We have so much to give and so much positivity. With this, we want to show the journey that we go through and what's happened in our area and how that's brought us together and how it's brought us into something very beautiful. In a sense, bringing everyone here, it's made a community in itself.
I got asked to do a mural for the community. Being from this area, I know exactly who the community are. I've got a friend that lives right over there in those houses. And so I know that this thoroughfare is like used day by day. Kids going to school, people going to the skate park, people going to work. I spoke to people walking past over the course of about a week. I said, what would you want from a mural here? Because I didn't want to just be an artist that came in and just stamped my work on and just left it. People really wanted colour back in the area, they wanted energy back in the area. I wanted to celebrate people's heritage from this area, but also the fact that we come together to form something new.
What I've gone for this exhibition was digital illustration. So using software, using graphic tablets to produce the art. I get inspiration from pretty much everything I see. So it's the now, which I can only document. It's what's happening literally right now. So I guess that's why it's got a current and fresh look to it.
The idea of this project was to prepare how we think about places here in neighborhoods. This is my way of giving something from me, how I feel being here. And this is important. It's personal. I'm here and I want to be a part of this place, simply.
Between fragile water droplets forming an ocean community. Even at the dark of night, the light still appears.
In paradise.
You've got poetry, you've got music, you've got, you know, a man like Clive on the keys just giving a little vibe. There's a real rhythm to what happens when people just create and let their work out.
Yeah, the night of the fire, so my wife and I, we lived in Bethel Tower.
If this tragedy was going to happen anywhere, it almost had to happen in this area because the resilience, the united spirit, even though everyone is so different, that we can get over those differences and come together and live in harmony. It's a lesson for not only the rest of London, but the rest of the country and the world.
I have had a really great time listening to all of these installations. They're all, you know, real stories from real people living in the area. It's been really heartwarming. Some of the stories are a bit sadder, some are happy, some are really funny.
I've been living here, Labrador, for 5 years now. The idea of having this love letter with older people is just a lovely way of showing people that it's not all about being young. I like the idea of that whole love letter and the idea of how you would take a relationship and create, so as a miniaturist, to create this sort of scene.
Hi, my name's Leo. I'm from Produce Moon and I'm one of the lead artists on Manifest.
Hi, my name's Cedrica and I'm the safeguarding pastoral lead on Manifest.
Hi, my name's Patricia. I'm Produce Moon's community producer for Manifest.
Hey, my name is Elsabet. I am a movement artist and one of the lead artists working on Manifest.
Hi, my name's Lauren. I'm a drag king and I'm one of the lead artists for Manifest.
Hi, my name's Mel. I'm the co-artistic director of Produce Moon and I'm one of the lead artists on Manifest.
We have loved being part of the Westway Commissions programme. In particular, the way it's kind of invited us to make relationships and form new relationships with organisations and young people across North Kensington. In particular, we have been running workshops at the Venture Centre and generating the piece at the Venture Centre as well, and they've been a really wonderful partner for us on this project.
And in the immediate future, so we didn't get to do our sharing in the way that we wanted because of the virus, so we're pushing that back. And we'll see sort of how things turn out, but when it becomes safe again, we're definitely going to get in touch with all those young people and have a day where we all come back together and eat lots of food and discuss the project and try and remember all the choreography, and then have our sharing in the future, yeah.
So the project is looking at songs that arguably were traditional or folk songs and would have been potentially sung orally and passed on through an oral tradition.
Portobello Road, Portobello Road, street where the riches of ages are stowed, anything and everything.
The focus there then for this project has been about looking at that through the lens of the Westway Portobello area.